I am literally all in black today. Literally. Don't mind my hair, it's still damp. I was gonna wait a couple more hours to film, but I just could not. Also because the people who are currently doing my basement renovations just went out for lunch and now I have a time to actually film when they can't hear me, so I took this opportunity, so. Just to clear that up. Yeah, as you guys know, it's been a struggle filming in a house where people are constantly sawing or hammering the walls or destroying things. I mean, they're fixing things, but they're also cutting things up and destroying them. So it's been a madhouse, so I'm taking this opportunity when they're on their lunch to film. Also, as you can see, I took my heart monitor off. I'm not supposed to, but I've been having a really bad skin reaction to all the little sticky electrodes on my chest. So I thought maybe I'll take it off for a couple hours, give my skin a breather. I don't know if you're supposed to do that, but I'm doing it. Never follow my lead, people. So before we get into this video, if you guys didn't see yesterday, I have new merch on my website. Usually when it gets closer to Christmas, I release a bunch of new stuff. So yesterday I was talking about how I now have mermaid socks on my website. They're so cool. They come in 4 different patterns and colors. They go all the way up to your knees, so they look really awesome in skirts or wherever you want to wear them, in dresses, I don't know. And they are limited edition, so we only have, I think now we only have like 21 left on the website. So get them while you can, and if they do run out of stock, if they're really high in demand, I will get some more. Really depends on how you guys respond to them. And you know how a couple weeks ago I was talking about if you have your notification bell on, you are a notification narwhal. That's what I have called you. I love narwhals. They're so cute and cuddly and beautiful and sparkly and magical. So, and call me a child if you want to, but I got some notification narwhal merch. I am so weird, but literally, oh my gosh, I have to show you these. They're so cute. I have notification narwhal plushies on my merch site for Christmas. I know I'm almost 25, but I like collecting plushies still. I'm still like 2 years old and they're so cute. I just have them on my bed and they're just, oh. So there's the 3 really small notification narwhals. And then if you're like a real powerful notification narwhal, there is a giant one. Hello! So these are also up on my website right now. The link to the mermaid socks and the notification narwhals are down below in the description. And if you aren't a notification narwhal yet, hit that bell. What you doing? Why are you just sitting there doing nothing? Hit the bell. Hit the bell. And let me know if you are one down below as well. Anyways though, I'm sorry I have such long intros. Every time I come to sit down and film, I tell myself, Jessie, try and do a 30-second intro. You can do it. Put your mind to it. You're fine. No one wants to hear 3 minutes. And then I sit down and film and it never happens that way. But I've been doing it since I started YouTube videos, so if you guys are still here, then you must not mind too much, I don't know. So as you guys know, I do have a security camera outside my house. It keeps me safe, it makes me feel protected, and I have caught a lot of really strange things on that. I've made tons of videos about the strange ghost orbs, weirdly long cat, people on my porch, haunted doll. I've literally, everything has been on my front porch apparently. So I was really intrigued when I found this article online showing a bunch of weird things that other people have caught on their motion cameras or security cameras. So I thought that I would sit down here and share those with you today. They do have the pictures with the stories, so I love when I have stories that have evidence with it. I feel like it's more interesting, you guys like it more, and it's just, it's all a better thing, you know? Wow, my hair is drying really poofy. Okay. Okay, so this first post was made by someone who has the username called Deleted. Deleted, I don't know. But it's called Ghost Woman Caught on Motion Sensor Camera. It says, this is a picture of a ghost woman we think we captured on a friend's motion sensor camera on their property in rural Virginia. There are cameras all around the house and all the entrances and exits of the property are covered. So they're like full out protected with their cameras. She is only seen leaving but never coming in. The camera is black and white because it's dark outside when it was captured and it creeped us all out. Okay, so I'm gonna click on this picture. I haven't seen it yet, so I don't know. This is gonna be like a jump scare, I don't know. Okay, so here is the picture. That is so weird. It doesn't even look like a human. And like, how would you even explain that rationally? Because that's not an animal, clearly. Unless it's a person running by the camera really, 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 really fast. But you have to be like the Flash to do that, so I don't know. And it almost looks like she's holding on to her arm for some reason. Like, is she an injured ghost? Like, what is happening? But yeah, if I woke up in the morning and I looked at my previous like camera recordings and this was on it, it would really freak me out. And I wish there was a video of it, but I guess a lot of people's cameras just capture pictures. Mine does that too. It does like both, it does both pictures and videos. So I think for each picture I should say if I think it's legit or not. This one, I'm like on the fence. I'm like in the middle of yes and no. So I don't know. Tell me what you guys think. I'm also gonna link each article down below in the description. Okay, this one also freaks me out so much. It's called A Mom Receives a Disturbing Text from the Nanny Cam. It says, one night while the mother of the little boy in the photograph above was at work, even though her husband was home, she decided to check the security camera notifications so she could sneak a peek of her little boy while she was away. What she saw instead was absolutely terrifying. The little boy doesn't seem very phased as he plays in his bed, but behind him, there seems to be a pretty terrifying looking man. Imagine the mother's horror when seeing someone so terrifying close to her baby. She ended up calling the father and freaking out only to find out that she was pranked by her husband. So this is proven as a hoax, but the image is still terrifying. Oh my gosh, you have no idea the relief I felt when I read that line that it's just her husband. When Ty and I have kids, if he ever does this to me, whoo, whoo. It's kind of good he doesn't watch my videos because then he might get some ideas, so. Now he won't, hopefully. This next one is just called Strange Creature, and it was posted by the vitamin underscore K. Vitamins are good for you. So it says, a little background on this image. This was taken by my aunt's motion camera around 2 to 3 years ago, and since then, I've come across the image again, and at first I thought it must be an owl of some sort, since they are pretty common around the main area. But the more I look at it, the stranger it gets, and I have no idea what this thing could be. Any help would be appreciated. So let's click on this image. It's so freaky because I just see a link, like I can't preview the image, so once I click on it, it's just right in front of me on my laptop. Okay, ready? Oh my goodness, what in the world? It looks like an, yeah, it looks like an owl creature. It looks like if an owl was like powered up. What is this, a video game? I don't know, it's like an owl times 200. It's like beast owl, monster owl, right? Like, I don't know what that is. It could just be like an owl landing on the porch, but the way the picture was taken, it like stretched out its body. I don't know. Cameras can do weird glitchy things sometimes. Like that cat that was on my porch, it could have just been a glitch where the camera just sort of extended its body. I don't really know. Let me know what you guys think of this creature down below. I think a lot of people in these comments were saying that it looks like Mothman or something. I don't know what Mothman is. Should I look up Mothman? I'm gonna look up Mothman. Oh, that's the Mothman. Interesting. It kind of looks like a big bat. In West Virginia folklore, the Mothman is a creature reportedly seen in the Point Pleasant area from November 12, 1966 to December 15, 1967. So it was only seen around for a year. Interesting. It says, people claim to see a man-like figure fly low from the trees over their heads. This is often identified as the first known sighting of what became known as the Mothman. Shortly after, on November 15th, 1966, two young couples from Point Pleasant, Roger and Linda Scarberry, and Steve and Mary Millette, told police they saw a large gray creature whose eyes glowed red when the car's headlight picked it up. They described it as a large flying man with 10-foot wings, following their car while they were driving in an area outside of the town known as the TNT area. People said it also looked like a large bird with red eyes. Oh my gosh, this goes on and on. There's so many accounts of this Mothman thing. There's even a statue of it in West Virginia. So people took that very serious. Wow. Sorry to get like off topic and everything. I didn't mean to. I was just like, people were saying that this thing looked like the Mothman. And it doesn't really? Someone also commented, not to sound crude or like a troll, but that honestly looks like a person in a dog mascot suit. But after reading a previous comment, it looks more like a lady picking something up off the porch. Oh, do you guys see that? Okay, that freaks me out even more because at first I saw like an owl man and now I'm seeing a lady bending down at the top of the step. Do you guys see that? Ugh, that's weird. Anyways, on to the next one, shall we? This one is posted by My Mom Can't Even. These are some really interesting usernames. So this next one is called Two Children Appearing to Be from the 1940s Were Playing in a Driveway and Caught on a Hidden Camera. That's creepy. So I'm gonna read like the little summary of it and then we'll look at it together. Are you ready? Okay, it says, my aunt sent me this photo in 2012. Sorry. She's young, was sane and lived alone. Someone kept taking down her flag at night, so she decided to set up a hidden camera. She used trail cam, typically used for hunting. If you're familiar with this camera, it takes consecutive bursts of photos when motion is detected. This photo was amongst a burst of photos that didn't show anything unusual. Only one frame showed this, which appears to be two blurred children dressed in clothing from another time. If you zoom in on the little girl's shoes, you see what I mean. You can even Google search this. It isn't anywhere else, and it isn't photoshopped or altered in any way. Also, why would two small children be in my single aunt's driveway past midnight? She does not have or live near any kids. We live in Michigan, so it's anywhere between 30 to 45 degrees on average in early November. You need a jacket, especially at night. My aunt bought her home in 2012 and has had lots of unexplained events happen to her in the home since then. Each year that has gone by, she seems to isolate more and more, and I'm worried it has something to do with something in her home. So now let's click on the link. Okay, are you ready? Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. Oh, ew. Yeah, it actually does, especially the one on the right. You can see the shoes and the legs. That is terrifying. And they must be walking really, really fast, or like doing some really fast motion, because you can't even see like their body because it's moving so fast. I don't know. I'm getting major creeps looking at this photo. Oh, it's just after midnight. I don't know. What do you guys think? Oh, I haven't been saying if I think they're legit or not. Okay, the last one was that thing that looked like a Mothman plus a person leaning over. I think that one's real, but I think it is actually just a person. This one, I think this could be real. I actually do. What do you guys think? Okay, this one freaks me out so much. And this one doesn't have a link, so I can already see the picture like on this article. And this one's called an unexpected visitor. It says, this Reddit user received notifications that someone was on his front doorstep. The man had come several times throughout the day, just staring into the camera each time. The scariest part of the image is the eerie smile he's giving the camera as he just blankly stares into the lens. This is not the kind of notification anyone would want, especially when it's letting you know who might be waiting outside your house. Oh my gosh. Do you think it's like a friend playing a joke on him or something? That's just so weird to me. And it looks like the guy's wearing like thick eyeliner. Okay, this next one is called A Burglar Watches a Baby Sleep. Ew. Ew, 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 ew. It says, this nanny cam one family used ended up capturing a burglar one night. And the scariest part was, the burglar stopped and stared at the baby for several minutes. When the police were notified, they checked out the house only to find that there was no sign of a forced entry, nothing missing, and pretty much no sign of the intruder at all, except for what was on the nanny cam. He had come for something and seen the cameras and decided it wasn't worth the risk. But was it someone the family knew trying to take something they might not notice was missing? The intruder still has not been found, and the terrifying occurrence only happened a couple months ago. Ooh, imagine like this person not being found. I swear, if anyone ever broke into my house or something, I would not sleep ever again if the police didn't find them. Like, that's terrifying to me. Anyways though, guys, there are so many pictures that I could go through right now, but I can't sit here and make a super long video because, as I said, I'm on a bit of a time constraint. The people that are renovating my house are gonna be back from lunch soon times. So if you want me to make a part two of this and show other really creepy hidden camera footage, definitely give this video a thumbs up and let me know, because there's so many more, like way too many. But yeah, anyways, don't forget, guys, if you want to win this backdrop behind me, all the rules were in my previous video. If you want to get your North Carolina tickets, I'm going to be there from the 10th to the 11th of November. Those tickets are down below in the description, along with the notification narwhal plushies and the mermaid socks. So a lot to take in, guys, but literally every single link is down below so you won't forget. And yeah, I hope you guys have an awesome rest of your day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!